The role of Madama Butterfly is definitely one of the most difficult, I could say. And it has many, many challenges. One of them is obviously music, which is amazing. It's a huge role. You are on the stage all the time. Second, big challenge is the personage, because we are in the theater and it's a beauty. You have to enter into something which is completely not you. You have to try to understand a different culture, to apply it yourself, and to filter it through your emotions and sing it out. So it's a long process. It took me, I could say, maybe 10 years, because I was looking into the Japanese culture. I was in Japan, I was studying, I was reading books about geisha. But obviously, that's not enough. That's not enough. It needs really an approach on stage with music and searching for the look in all senses, you know, white face, wig, changing your features, changing my eye color. It's a big and a nice and interesting journey, I could say. And definitely, music-wise, I didn't plan to take Butterfly so soon. I was thinking, okay, I should wait for maybe other 8 years. Then I looked into the score and I thought, but she is a girl, she's 15, it's not a symphonical music concert. Okay, somebody might say I don't have really the voice so big, so huge, so dramatic to do the Butterfly, but I said, but Butterfly, it's not Turandot. So, and Turandot also is young, by the way, but the scrittura, the orchestration, the fragility of her, of 15 years old Japanese girl, the traditions, all this together, it made me want to create the girl. I don't know how much I will succeed. I hope I will succeed. Obviously, the first Butterfly is not 10th Butterfly, but it was a big challenge also for me and Maestro Fogliani. We were working a lot and we were searching for these specific colors, for specific movements. And obviously, the whole role has to be like a one jewel. So it's a long journey, but in the end, it's a one personality. I would say this is the story of a woman who tries to cheat herself. She's trying not to see the reality in any possible way. Whatever comes, she turns it into the way how she wants to see it. And when the reality comes, there are a few things where, like, when Sharpless first tells her, what are you going to do when she's not going to come, when he's not coming. And it's the first moment where she realizes, oh, maybe she knows deep inside, she knows that he might not come, but she doesn't want to admit it. She doesn't want to see it. She's fleeing the reality in all the possible ways. And obviously, when reality comes and hits it on the third act, the only way out is the honest way of committing a suicide, because it was an honor to commit the suicide in the right way. So it's very interesting, very big difference between a Christian culture of it being a big sin to commit a suicide and the Japanese way of seeing of committing a suicide as an honest way, yeah, of, as she says, one has to die with honest on in an honest way when you couldn't live the life in the honest way. Well, that's very often said, that it's too many voices in one singer in Butterfly, in Traviata, but it's not true. The composer was very wise. He knew what he was writing, you know. When he was thinking about a specific thing, he would put a piano or a forte or fortissimo to describe a specific dolcezza, we call it, the softness of the character. He would put forte going into two pianos and then into piano, which never shows this roughness, which is this with a certain sense of elegance in the personage. So I wouldn't say it's many voices voices. It's just the same woman who changes, and she's girl, she becomes a woman and a mother, and then she loses everything. For her, when she says tutto è finito per me, everything is finished, that's it. So from there we see a live walking dead woman, because she decided she's going to do it. It's just the question how much strength it takes to her to commit a suicide. It's extremely important to understand that for me it's big, big honor to do this role, and I try my best to get as near to the Japanese culture as I can. Obviously, I will not succeed in everything, but by doing this role, I think Puccini and any person who is making this role is wanting to say a big thank you and a big, bringing a big honor to the Japanese culture.